what's up? It's me, Arthi, and you're watching the Wednesday vlog. And Wednesday gyan jo main lekar aati hu har Wednesday ko. So this is the part 2 of the video that I did last week. Last week we spoke about how to deal with criticism, but that time I only dealt with constructive criticism, and I said because there's so much to talk about on this topic, I'll talk about how to deal with the critics, cynics and the mean-spirited attacks that you come across in day-to-day life, jisko hum internet slang mein haters kehte hain. So aaj hum uske bare mein baat karne wale hain. But before I get started with that topic, please do not forget to hit the subscribe button so you know you can see more of this content that I'm making just for you guys. This video is for anybody and everybody jinko lagta hai, you know, at some point in their life or currently in their life they are dealing with a lot of negativity and toxic feedback coming their way from a parent, a teacher, a boss in the office, a friend in the social circle, on the internet, and especially if you are in the creative field and you are putting yourself out there and you're trying to present your work on the digital media, you're going to get the good and the bad feedback. And the bad can sometimes range from the constructive, the helpful one, the not so constructive one, to the absolutely destructive, self-esteem crushing kind of a feedback. And that's exactly what we are talking about today. Touch wood, I've been very lucky since I've started this vlog. Up tak, I haven't really received hate. Because I'm in the very initial phase, I'm only receiving the good, positive, helpful, you know, feedback that's helping me grow. Of course, ek do comment aaye hai kuch kuch video ke niche, which I just look at them, I feel like, oh, he's having a bad day, and overlook it and move on, because you can't spend your energy, I mean, in such kind of feedback. But I haven't still yet received the major hate. Not like I'm waiting for it or asking for it, I'm just saying I haven't. So whenever that happens, that will be some experience, and I think this entire video is going to come handy for me only when that happens. But right now, continuing, so it's very important to understand the psychology, like why do people say the things they say to you. My best learning in this regard has come from one of my favorite authors, Brene Brown, and her books that I have been reading over the past few months. What she says about critics and cynics is, whenever you are at the receiving end of continuous toxic feedback, remarks that are not meant to uplift you but put your spirits down, remarks that are just spiteful, hurtful, mean and meant to make you feel bad, you have to understand it always comes from the place of somebody being unhappy with themselves. Those people might have unresolved issues inside themselves that they're not sitting and dealing with and solving. They are instead offloading it onto others, people around them, in the form of anger, in the form of resentment, judgments, in the form of criticism. So these are just ways of offloading your own hurt and pain onto others. A lot of times people are not living their own life to the fullest. So when they see somebody else doing that, these things just come out automatically. So people who are hard on others all the time are really extremely hard on themselves. And while you understand these facts, it's also not right to judge all of them, because you might have maybe say a parent in your life who's been like extremely critical about everything you do, or to a level cynical. They are just modeling their own parents or their own surroundings that they have grown up in, and they just do not know any other way to do it. If there is somebody very close to you in your life jo is tarah ka behavior dikhata hai, they might really be in the need of help, and you should go out there and see in which way can you help. But if this behavior comes from somebody from your outer circle and not the inner circle, then the best way to deal with them is just ignore these kind of hate comments. I know it's very easy to say ignore karo, aage badho, but when it comes to actually implementing it, itna asan nahi hai. Especially if you posted something which is very close to your heart and somebody like writes an entire paragraph underneath it just to demean you, wo jo initial like pinch hota hai na andar, like you feel like a mini heartburn, and it's like real, like in that moment, like that anger has gone to your head and you want to type out every mean thing to that person. And it will happen how much of a wise you are. Like, we are all human at the end of the day, but what's important is how you take control of the situation after that 10 seconds of that initial rage and how you react to it. Ab tum log bologe, Aarti, ye sab to theek hai, but what are the practical things to keep in mind when you see hate coming your way? These are the 5 things that have helped me a lot. Number 1 is this quote, and this quote, jab se maine ye padha hai, it has just stuck with me, and trust me, it's one hell of a motivating quote, especially if you are in the creatives and trying to put your work out there and receiving like bad feedback. This will open your perspective like anything. It's very interesting. Dhyan se suno. It's by Theodore Roosevelt. It says, it's not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who's actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes short again and again, because there is no effort without error and shortcoming. But who does actually strive to do the deeds, who knows great enthusiasms, great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at worst, if he fails, at least fails while daring greatly. The whole sar of this quote, agar bahut zyada angrezi ho gaya, tough words ho gaya, isko google kar lena, pad lena, but the whole sar is, it does not matter what people are saying about your work. What matters is you're actually putting yourself out there, you're actually in the arena, you're actually playing the game, and you're actually kind of living life on the edge and not just living a safe, secure life. And there are no achievements without errors and shortcomings. So if sometimes you put out some work out there, it is not as great as work you'd want to be, it's okay. It's a process. I mean, you can't always have the best and perfect work out there. You're going to make your mistakes. But the point is to continue the process and become better while you do it. So this quote is really one of those quotes, you know, which will stay with me till the end of my life. I know, too dramatic, but it is one of those. It's like bloody powerful. Number two, while we say it's not the critic who counts, it's also important to remember that when we stop caring about what people think, we lose our capability of connection. And when we become defined by what people think, we lose our willingness to be vulnerable, to put ourselves out there, to be, you know, to reach our highest form of expression. So how do you deal with it? So what Brene says is, it's almost like walking like on a tightrope. Like, you have to be very like clear about what feedback are you taking and which ones are you dropping, and how will this be possible? This will only be possible if you're clear about one very, very, very important thing for everybody in the world, that your self-worth is not attached to the last work that you did, or to the profession that you're in, or to the talent that you're portraying. Your self-worth is your birthright. It belongs to you no matter what kind of work you're putting out today. So the moment we attach somebody's feedback or a comment with our self-worth is where the problem starts, is where we start judging ourselves because of them judging us. Agar wo hamare dimag mein clear hai na, that I'm worthy and I'm putting my best work out there. If you're happy inside about what you're doing, I don't think what the outer world says will matter to you much. Number three, another important thing that the Theodore Roosevelt quote teaches us is, if you're not in the arena also getting your ass kicked, I'm not interested in your feedback. These are the exact words from Brene Brown, and I saw them in an interview with Oprah, I think, and I was like, fuck, that makes so much sense. Like, that again opened something for me. It was like one of those Oprah's aha moments. If you're not out putting yourself out there, if you are also not being vulnerable, then I don't need feedback from you. If you are not open to receiving feedback the way you give it to me, and when I put my point forth, you feel attacked or insulted or offended, then this exchange doesn't need to happen. Number four, and this is like a gem, take a chit, 1 inch by 1 inch cup. Write the names of 4 to 5 people, or even lesser, jitne kam se kam log us chit pe fit ho sakte, unke naam likho. These people have to be those people whose feedback means a lot to you, and these people have to be those people who know you in and out, who've seen the best and the worst of you. The moment I heard about this, I made my little 1 by 1 inch ka chit, jisme maine apne 4-5 logo ke naam likhe hue, whose feedback is the most important to me. So whenever I am received with hate, there are two things I can do. I can put the hate away and go to these people and ask them, what do they think of the work that I have done? Or those people are my safety net, because I know whenever I fall, they are going to be there to give me a hand and pick me up. And the fifth thing to remember, your haters are the people who need help. And I do not mean this in the demeaning way. But think about it. You have to deal with them for a few hours if you go to a workplace, for a few minutes or seconds on the internet. But they have to deal with them, their own selves, the garbage in their mind, for their entire life. They just might be people who just need a hug in real life. And if you're anything like me, if you're oversensitive and touchy about things a lot in life, you have to remember, you are not what people say about you. They are what they say about you. If you remember this one thing, I think it becomes very easy to deal with anything that's coming your way. So if this video was helpful to you, please hit the like button and please let me know in the comments below. I love listening to your feedback. Mujhe aap yahan par bhi bata sakte ho, ya fir aap mujhe Instagram pe DM bhi kar sakte ho. Meri Instagram ki profile link sare video descriptions mein niche hai. So we can chit chat on Insta and all that. And on that note, I'm going to take off and see you guys this Friday. You guys take care. Bye.